sis, when you was up there bragging and knowing that you just got pregnant by this man that just had all these babies everywhere else, did you ever think about how you was going to spend your Christmas? You know, did you ever think about how many holidays and how many school trips and all this stuff, how this man's going to be able to show up to support you in the midst of him pursuing that high earning income that he's doing? Do you really think that you're going to have the help and the support? He's going to send you a check. That's it.
Do you feel like it's worse to choose the wrong person to marry or the wrong person to have a child with? Which one of those do you think is worse?
So I would say the child, because now you're affecting a person who didn't ask to be here, and you have a permanent situation with this person. And, you know, being that I am a single parent now, and a high earning person which is the new trend of what people call people, but my significant other at the time was a high earning person. And I think that a lot of times when women look at that, they look at money. Money cannot buy you half of the stuff that you're compromising when you're in these relationships with them. Because 9 out of 10, you're not the only person. I don't care what they say. I don't care how many diamond rings they buy you, how many cars, whatever it is. 9 out of 10, you're not the only person. So when you look at that, ask yourself, how much is that person paying to have you? You know, what are you selling yourself for? Because, you know, it, especially when, I know I'm kind of going off on a tangent, but I promise I'm going somewhere.
Nah,
the thing with Nick Cannon that disturbs me, right, is how everybody is so comfortable with being a baby mama. Is your expectations so low that that's all you're striving for, right? And then because I am the mother of a child that is in a situation with a high earning person who had other children prior to me and even after me, that's not a comfortable position to be in when you have to negotiate how you're going to spend your holidays with somebody, how you want to parent your children, you know, what vacations you guys are going to do. Like, you have to plan every single detail of your life with this other person, whether or not you are in a relationship with that person at all. These are the downsides of being in a situation with somebody that you're not married to. And I'm not saying that it's going to get better because you're married to them, because if you ask a lot of women who are married and have children, they'll say a lot of the responsibility still falls on them as the mother in the relationship. But what I'm trying to get women to understand is, don't think so low of yourself that that's the best that you can do. And if you're doing it for just a check, that's a short-term thing. When you look at all the agony and embarrassment and the shame that comes if you have consciousness of being in that situation, it's not a comfortable situation. Now, when I look at my situation and I think about it without a bias, right? I recognize that I'm very blessed because we're able to not really have any of these hiccups. But I can also insert myself into a situation where that may not be the case. So when you look at Nick Cannon and he has, you know, how many other kids he had this year with all these different women, sis, when you was up there bragging and knowing that you just got pregnant by this man that just had all these babies everywhere else, did you ever think about how you was going to spend your Christmas? You know, did you ever think about how many holidays and how many school trips and all this stuff, how this man's going to be able to show up to support you in the midst of him pursuing that high earning income that he's doing? Do you really think that you're going to have the help and the support? He's going to send you a check. That's it. So when you think about putting yourself in those situations, and I know sometimes it ain't planned. My pregnancy was not planned. And it's easy to always go and just, you know, do what you do and handle your business. But the thing is that so many of us take children and motherhood like it's a badge, like you're getting a reward for it. And it's more complex than what it seems to be, you know? So if you're finding yourself dating somebody and you don't have children, try your best to stay out of that situation, right? Because no matter how much you think that they've changed, they try to tell you how special you are, how much you made a difference, whatever little game they playing, unless they marry you, and even if they marry you, that don't mean it's got to stay there. So let's put that out there, right? The point is that it's more than a notion that anybody could ever explain to you. And a lot of times when these women are sitting up on their pedestals and having these conversations, they're not telling you the downsides of it. When you're tired, when if you got boys, your daddy, they daddy not there, so they trying you with little boy stuff. It's so much stuff, right? Both children deserve both parents for them to be well-rounded and to be self-sufficient, loving, mentally healthy, and stable children in the future, or an adult, right? They both deserve that. And you rob yourself of that help, as well as rob your children of what they need to be able to be successful in life, because now you're shouldering a responsibility that was never yours to carry on your own. And that's something that most people would never have the audacity to tell you. And I'm telling you this because I'm in that situation, and that's something that I don't care how many times I pray about it and I ask God to give me strength, there's still a day that comes where I'm just like, now what? You know what I mean? Like, now what? Or with the days where I'm sitting there and I'm just like, okay, so you got Thanksgiving this year, I got Christmas, like, or we have to split birthdays. Like, we're doing this stupid stuff. You know what I mean? And it's just like, this is crazy. So I just want people to know that when you go after these high earning people and you find yourself being satisfied with being it, think about the full picture holistically and what that looks like when you're going through it, because nobody's going to tell you the truth. Everybody's going to give you a thumbs up, a like, a yelling emoji, and all of that stuff. But when you're tired, when you don't have a babysitter, when you don't have anybody to relieve you, when you just need a moment to yourself, think about that then. You know, and that'll make you straighten up real quick and say, you know what, I don't think dating somebody of this caliber is in my league. So let me stay to my league. And they're going to try to pursue you, you know, especially if they're somebody who used to getting whatever they want. But that's where your discernment, to Shayla's point, comes in. That's where your prayer comes in. That's where we have to know, you know, it's not about the glitz and glamour, like what Asia said, of social media. It's about what's in my lane and what feels good to me and what does God have for me in the best of what it is that he has for me. And if we believe that, then that's what we got to stand on and not be easily deceived about what the devil is pushing with his agenda on social media. You know, sign off, go follow some people that's married and have a great day, and just, you know, just put that in the front of your mind, you know, because it's happened to us so many times. I mean, every young woman that you think about, like I glanced through Summer Walker's album, you know, you just hear it, you know, it's there. And only a woman that's been there knows what that story feels like. And we owe it to each other to have that real conversation with each other and let other women know, sis, it ain't worth it. You know, it ain't worth it. I don't care if you are getting $6,000 a month, sis, it ain't worth it. Like, you can't pay nobody to show up to help you. So that's all that I have to say about that. And, you know, I feel bad for Danny Lee. I did DM her and told her, you know, like, I don't know what's going on in trying to be your business, but I know what that feels like, being a single mom and being new and feeling like the person that you need to be dependable on that got you in this mess when they're not there and turn their back on you. I know what that feels like, you know, and just keep your head up. So that's the type of encouragement that women need to have when they're in that situation. And we really need to educate our sisters on how to make better choices when it comes to the partner.